j'ai pas d'avançon. J'ai pas d'avançon. Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul. We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome.
But as we gather under your feet again to hear your word of life, let your word bring healing, let your word sanctify, let your word purify us, let your word reawaken our spiritual consciousness in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord God Almighty, I surrender my body, soul, and spirit unto you. Speak to me and speak through me this hour, that the hearer will be blessed. I that you are using will be blessed, and our faith will be strengthened. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray with thanksgiving.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, as time will permit us, we are looking briefly at a brief exhortation titled Knowing the Power of Your Tongue, or better still, The Power of Your Tongue. Amen. Knowing the power of your tongue. Brethren, possessing knowledge or understanding the power of your tongue is very, very important. This is where many Christians have failed, even the entire world have failed. The problem we have in the world today is as a result of the power of the tongue. The tongue have set the world in total fiasco. The tongue have set the entire world into total confusion. Brethren, the Lord is reminding you and I again this hour for us to know the efficacy and the physical and the spiritual potency of the power of your tongue. Brethren, if a bad tongue enter this ministry, except the Lord intervene, everybody will scatter. The tongue is very, very powerful. That is why we need to weigh and appraise every word that comes out of our mouth before we speak it out. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Brethren, according to the dictionary meaning of the tongue, it said it's a flexible muscular organ in the mouth that is used to move food around for tasting, and that is to move into various positions to modify the flow of air from the lungs in order to produce different sound in speech. Brethren, you and I today, the reason why we are proclaiming that we are born again, or the reason why we proclaim the salvation that we claim to have, is as a result of the power of the tongue. Without the tongue, you remain dumb. Without the tongue, you will not be able to declare. Without the tongue, you will not be able to praise God. You can see the efficacy and the power of the tongue. So, brethren, the tongue is so powerful, but it's very small. The tongue can set the entire city on fire. The tongue can destroy you within a twinkle of an eye. Without the help or the aid of the tongue, speech, chewing, and tasting of food is absolutely, absolutely impossible. It also has a great spiritual function that many human beings, or better still, Christians have totally ignorance of. Brethren, ignorance, when I mean ignorance, I'm talking about a condition of being uninformed, uneducated, lack of knowledge or information. Like they will always say, ignorance is not an excuse of the law. If everybody will come and say the reason why I killed that man or the reason why I stole is because I was totally ignorant that it was a crime, nobody will be jailed. Everybody will be set free. That is why the law says ignorance is not an excuse of the law. Praise Master Jesus. When you are found guilty, when you are found guilty of it, you will be penalized accordingly. That is why it's very, very important for us to be informed. When you are informed, you will be transformed. But when you lack information, you will be deformed. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
The tongue is, ignorance is the mass weapon of destruction. Satan is using to send people to hell easily. People claim to be born again, but they don't know left from their right. They don't know what they are proclaiming. That is why in every country that you are, there is a law that has been set in order to keep the country in order, in order to checkmate it. That is how the word of God is to checkmate our life. Satan has succeeded in keeping people from the word of God so that they will be far from their God. The more you get closer to the word of God, the more you get closer to your God. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Like I always say, if you don't know that the red light is telling you to stop, you in the twinkle of an eye, you are gone. So, brethren, that is why information is very, very powerful. When you drive on the highway, you can see the communication, the motor that is coming on the right-hand side know where he's going to take. He or she is going to take. While the one coming on the left-hand side know where he's going to also take. That is communication. Brethren, when there is no good communication here right now, everything will be in tabula rasa, according to my apostle. There will be topsy-turvy. There will be anarchy. There will be lawlessness. Praise Master Jesus Christ. So, brethren, what are we talking about? The efficacy and the potency of the tongue. How are you using your tongue? How are you using your tongue? Are you using it to destroy, to set fire among people, or to set fire in your marriage, or to cause confusion, or to edify the body of Christ? Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
The Bible makes us to understand. It said, with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. The reason why you proclaim the salvation you have today, when you heard it, you have to speak it out. Lord Jesus, I come before you. I accept you. That is to tell you the potency of the tongue. That is to tell you the power of the tongue. Apostle Paul make me to understand in the book of 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 13. He said, who was before a blasphemer, a persecutor, an injurious, but I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly in unbelief. But there are many Paul that did that same thing, but they are in hell. Pastors are in hellfire. Deacons are in hellfire. Prophetess are in hellfire because they did not use their tongue well. And they did all they did ignorantly because they did not know what the word of God was saying concerning the efficacy and the potency of the tongue. The tongue is the smallest element or organ in our body, like I've earlier said, but it plays a significant role both physically and spiritually. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When Moses was confronted by the Red Sea, what God, when Moses got to that confusing situation, he has to call upon God. And God told Moses, tell the people to move forward. Tell the people to move forward. This is the power of the tongue. Tell them to move forward. Move forward. The sea will part. And immediately he told him, stretch your rod. And the sea parted. And the cross. And if you also study the word of God thoroughly, you will discover these same people that went through the Red Sea were being wasted in the wilderness. What cost it? The power of the tongue. They went to the promised land according to the book of Numbers chapter 14. They went, they searched out the land, they saw the good fruit, they even took from it. But when they came back, what did they do? They murmured with their tongue. They rebelled with their tongue. And God was listening. And as they finished their own, the Almighty God said, okay, you have done your own. It's time for me to do my own. And these people, they are being wasted in the wilderness. Why? Because of the power of the tongue. How are you using your tongue? Are you using it to destroy, or you are using it to edify the body of Christ? If you study that scripture thoroughly, you will discover it was only Caleb out of the 12 spies from each 12 tribes of Israel that was sent to that land that proclaimed life with their tongue. They told these people, they are bred before us. We will conquer, we will destroy them. Joshua, the son of Nun, and Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, they stood out. They used their tongue to proclaim positive. And God singled them out. Power of the tongue. Praise Master Jesus Christ. The Bible makes us to understand in the book of Proverbs chapter 15, verse 4, he said, wholesome tongue is a tree of life, but a perverse therein is a breach in the spirit. I take it again. A wholesome tongue is a tree of life, but a perverse therein is the breach in the spirit. What do I mean when I say wholesome? We are talking promoting good physical health and well-being. Promoting that your spiritual health and your spiritual well-being. Promoting morals and mental well-being. That is wholesome, a wholesome tongue. And if you also go to the book of Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21, it said, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. When Eve engaged himself with Satan, by battling words with Satan, as a result of that, he now disobeyed what God, the instruction God gave to her. What did he bring to herself? He brought death to herself, brought to her husband, an entire generation. That is how death we are set in course as a result of the power of the tongue. I want you to know the efficacy and the spiritual potency of the tongue. Remember what brought Samson down. When I begin to study the word of God, study the story of Samson, Samson was anointed right from his mother's womb. If Samson did not engage himself with conversation with Delilah, Samson would have finished well. But what happened? He saw the first sign, he did not learn lesson. But what happened? Because he was carried away by the ravishing beauty of Delilah, because he was carried away by the lap of Delilah, he never knew when he uttered the sacred secret of his destiny, of his life, of his being. This was a man that destroyed 1,000 Philistines with a jawbone of an axe. That is to tell the anointing that Samson was possessing. But because he did not know how to use his tongue, he revealed his secret and he was brought down to a piece of bread. They plucked off his two eyes and they tied him, and he became a puppet that they make mockery. So brethren, how are you using your tongue? He said, death and life are in the tongue. If you proclaim life with it, you have life. If you proclaim death, you have death too. He said, for he that will love life and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil and his lip, that they speak no guile. I take it again. For he that will love life and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil and his lip, that they speak no guile. Yesterday, I was listening to a conversation of a prominent man. Maybe most of us even read that book. There is a book when I was still in secondary school those days, though I was not a Christian then. They call it a manna. Something manna is a daily devotional guide.
Oh, yeah.
If you can still remember, that book is very, very, if you read the book, it makes sense. This is a daily devotional guide. What happened yesterday? This man was caught with a worker in the church who he engaged oral sex conversation with. The girl, as he was discussing, he record everything on the it is, you cannot deny it. That is to tell you how his tongue brought him down. You cannot believe that a man of God would be saying such a thing out of his mouth. I cannot say it. As I was listening to it, cold entered up my body. As the you know these people that know all these newscaster, all these journalists, they know how to mock people very well. As the man is saying those rubbish out of his mouth, they will be showing him how he was preaching in the church. The way he's using man to declare the word of God in the church, and he's also showing the way he's using man to say, oh my God, praise Master Jesus Christ. The tongue is powerful. The tongue is not a thing for us to joke with. That is why it's better to be silent than to speak sometimes. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, if you turn your Bible to the book of James chapter 1 verse 26, he said, if any man among you seems to be religious and bridle not his tongue, but deceive his own heart, the man's religion is vain. The ability for you to bridle your tongue is very, very, very important through the word of God. That is why the Lord is reminding me, is reminding you this hour for us to know the power of the tongue so that we will not be messed up with this same tongue that has been given to us as a weapon to tear down the kingdom of darkness and to populate the kingdom of God. So, brethren, the Bible makes us understand the book of Matthew chapter 12, verse 36. It said, but I say unto you that every idle word that a man shall speak, they shall give account thereof on the day of judgment. Can't you see how powerful the tongue is? There is a recorder that can never be uttered. There is a camera that is watching that you cannot utter, that is not subject to any technical fault, that right from creation, it has never been broken. Right from creation, the battery has never gotten weak. Right from creation, the lens has never got dim. It is recording you. It's like your shadow. You cannot run away from your shadow. There is a camera. That is why the Bible says you shall give account of every word that comes out of your mouth. In verse 37 of that same scripture, it said, by the words thou shalt be justified, and by the words thou shalt be condemned. Just like the way you and I were justified the day we make that positive proclamation, we accept the Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior. And he came into our life, and we received that justification through his mercy, through his blood, and through his grace. That is how some people will also receive condemnation into hell on the last day. I pray that will not be our portion in Jesus' name. Amen. If you turn your Bible to the book of Isaiah chapter 59, he said, but your iniquities have separated between you and your God. I'm reading Isaiah chapter 59, verse 2. He said, but your iniquity have separated between you and your God, and your sin have hidden his face from you, that he will not hear. Verse 3, for your hands are defiled with blood, and your fingers with iniquity. Your lips have spoken lies, your tongue have muttered perverseness. Verse 4, not collect for justice, nor any pleaded for truth. They trusted in vanity and speaketh lies. They conceived mischief and break forth iniquity. Verse 5. They hash cockatrice eggs. They are weevils and the spider web. He that eateth of their egg died, and that which is crushed break out into a viper. And if you go to verse 6, he said their webs shall not become garments. I take it again. Their webs shall not become garments. Neither shall they cover themselves with their work. Their works are more a work of iniquity, and their art of violence is in their hand. He said their feet run to evil, and they make haste to shed innocent blood. Their thoughts are thought of iniquity, wasting and destruction are in their path. So, brethren, see that scripture that we have read now, verse 4. He said, nor called for justice, nor pleaded for truth. They trusted in vanity. And that mouth and tongue has brought destruction. It has brought calamity to the life of many people. Some of the problem we are going through now is as a result of the tongue, what we use our mouth to sow years back ago. Though we have been forgiven, but we are still enjoying the dividends of what our mouth sowed 5 years ago, or 10 years ago, or the lies we told 10 years ago. The restitution we are doing now is a restitution that is a result of the sin, or what we do, will I call it, in the days of our ignorance. So people are even still finding it very difficult to do it because of what we use our mouth and what we use our life to do in the days of our ignorance. That is why Apostle Paul makes us to understand when he was admonishing Timothy, he says, study to show thyself approved unto God, for a workman needed not to be ashamed, but rightly divided the word of truth. And in the book of John chapter 17, verse 17, he says, sanctify them with the truth, for the word is truth. Will you allow history to repeat itself again? The history of iniquity and sin to repeat itself again in our life? As you and I, we have been totally informed with the power and the efficacy of the tongue? I guess our answer will be no. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Rounding up now. Brethren, if you take a look at the Tower of Babel, when they started, they were speaking one language. If you study the book of Genesis chapter 11 from verse 1 to 9, the Bible makes us to understand that we are building and everything we are going very beautiful. It was in progress. And God watched from heaven. If we leave these people like this, these people, they will actualize their aim. They will fulfill it. They will get to us. What do we do? He confronted them with what? With divers tongues. That is where the languages came up. If I was telling the apostle yesterday, please give me water. And today, I'm not telling the apostle beer. What will the apostle say? He'll say, what is wrong with you? You are stupid. You don't know what you are saying. This one will say, you are stupid. That is how they abandon the Tower of Babel. And they abandon it. That is to tell you the efficacy of the tongue. Brethren, I prophesy upon you and upon my life that every enemy of our soul, they shall fall down and crumble like the Tower of Babel in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Brethren, Korah, Dathan, Abiram rebelled. Numbers chapter 16, when you take it from verse 1 to 35, time will not permit us. They rebelled. What caused it? The tongue. Tongue brought condemnation unto them. And Moses said, if they die a natural death, they will know that he's not serving, it's not God that called him. And what happened? Earth opened. And Korah, Abiram, Dathan, and his entire household, and his innocent children that knew nothing, enter into that same pit. And the earth closed his mouth as if he did not swallow anything. The tongue. In James chapter 3 from verse 1, he said, my brethren, be not many masters, knowing that ye shall receive greater condemnation. Verse 2, for in many things we offend all. If any man offend not in his word, the same is a perfect man, and is able also to bridle his own body. Verse 3, he said, behold, we put bits in the horse's mouth that they may obey us, and we turn about their whole body. Verse 4, and behold, also the sheep, also which though they be so great and are driven of a fierce wind, yet are they turned about with a very small hand, whichsoever the governor listed. Verse 5, even so the tongue is a little member and boasted great things. Behold, how great matter a little fire kindled. Verse 6, he said, the tongue is a fire, a word of iniquity. So is the tongue among our members that defileth the whole body and set it on fire, the cause of nature. It is set on fire of hell. Verse 7, for every kind of beast and of birds and of serpent and of things in the sea is tame. He said, and hath seen and hath been tame of mankind. Verse 8, he said, but the tongue can no man tame. It is unruly evil, full of deadly poison. Verse 9, therewith we bless with God, even the Father, and therewith we curse we men, which are made after the similitude of God. 10, out of the same mouth proceeded blessing and cursing. My brethren, this thing ought not to be so. Doeth a fountain send forth at the same time sweet water and bitter? I guess the answer is no. The fountain will only send sweet water. When he sends this sweet water, it can never be mixed together with bitter water. So, brethren, the Lord is admonishing you and I that we should use our tongue to edify. Our tongue is the vehicle of our destiny. And I pray, whatsoever any negative cause we have set in place with our tongue, it is neutralized this morning by the power of the Holy Ghost and the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Time will not permit us. The conclusion. Whoso keepeth his mouth and his tongue, keepeth his soul from trouble. I pray as many of us that have heard this word this hour, we will learn to keep our mouth shut where we are supposed to keep it, and our tongue, so that we'll be able to keep our soul for eternity in Christ Jesus. May the Lord bless this word in our heart and make it prosperous in Jesus' name. Are you there? You have not yet given your life unto Jesus. All what you have been using your tongue for is for the devil. So come out of the camp of the devil now by accepting him as your Lord and personal Savior, by saying this brief word of confession after me. Say, Lord Jesus Christ, I come before your presence this morning. I know I am a wretched sinner. I know I am not worthy of standing before you. Have mercy upon me. Forgive me all my sins. Let my sins be blotted out and my name be blotted out from the book of death and hell, and let it be written in the book of life. Lord Jesus, I accept you today as my Lord and personal Savior. Lord Jesus Christ, come into my life. Take total control of my life and let your name alone be glorified. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
You have just said that brief prayer of confession. Heaven is already rejoicing over your soul. And we as a family will rejoice with you. And I pray with you. Father, I bring these ones before you. I dip them into the pool of the blood of Jesus. But I ask, O Lord, that you strengthen them, you empower them, you grant them the grace and strength to remain faithful, to remain holy, to remain righteous to the end in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, henceforth, they will continue to speak their tongue, to praise your name, to edify your name, to edify their spirit, and to grow in the faith in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord God Almighty, I put your seal upon their life. Thank you, Father. Henceforth, let no man trouble them. Let no demon trouble them. For they bear the mark of the Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
In 1 minute, let's talk to the Lord. Say, Father, I need your grace to be obedient to your word. Father, grant me the grace to use my tongue to glorify you, to edify my spirit and people around me. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord. My Father, my God, my Redeemer, my Savior, King of Kings, O Lord, omnipotent God, I surrender my tongue, Lord, unto you. I need your grace to use my tongue to the edification of your body, to the edification of your name, to proclaim your name, to declare your name, to preach your word, not to destroy anymore. I refuse to use my tongue to destroy myself, to destroy my family, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My Father, my God, my Savior, help me, Lord, help my wife, my children, for us to use our tongue positively in the mighty name of Jesus. And that henceforth, evil shall proceed out of my tongue anymore in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, to be watchful of every word that comes out of my mouth in the mighty name of Jesus. Help me to bridle my tongue. Thank you, Father. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praised. Amen. As we all have decreed and declared in one accord, so shall it be established in Jesus' name. Amen. Almighty and most everlasting Father, we thank you.
Holy Spirit, deliver me.
Amen.
Want you to make me to be. Please, Father, in Jesus' name.
Almighty and most everlasting Father, we thank you, we bless you, we adore you, we magnify your name, we give you all the praise, we give you all the honor. Father, Lord God Almighty, you have spoken crystal clear again unto us. Father, as I've spoken out of point, I ask for your mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I pray that this word will not be used against me. On the last day, will not be used against the hearer, but we'll continue to renew our mind and make every one of us rapture ready in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I pray every powers of darkness that want to defy this world, that want to make us to forget so easily, let that power be consumed in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I pray that this word will not be diluted in us, but rather it shall remain fresh and pure in us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That power to receive and retain, I pray every one of us receive it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray with thanksgiving.
Amen. Amen.
But you know.
Praise the Lord.
Bishop of our soul, shepherd of our soul.